Blackstone presents Felonious Monk by William Kotzwinkle. This book is read by Chris Henry Coffey.
1. Midnight kidnappings, street warfare, and murder in broad daylight are typical for Modelo. It's in the sovereign state of Chihuahua, Mexico. I was supposed to be in the sovereign state of grace, as a monk in the monastery of San Juan Diego. I fell from grace one afternoon. I went to Modelo to buy hay and oats for our horses. The monastery had been my home for the past 5 years, during which a drug lord known as the Camel came to power in Modelo.
"Hey, Brother Martini, how you doing?"
called the regulars loafing about as I parked the monastery truck at the feed store. I answered them in the passable Spanish I'd learned during my 5 years. Strictly speaking, I shouldn't have talked to them, but the monastery relaxes that rule in the interest of getting along in town. On the day I fell from grace, I was approached by a woman I'd never met before, but it was clear she had been waiting for me. "Father, can you help me?" I was only 26 years old and hardly worthy of being called father. She was about 30, and her clothes looked homemade. She was poor, and there was pain in her face. "I'm at your service, Senora." "The layabouts are watching us," she said. "Can you walk with me away from such eyes?"
We walked toward the plaza fountain. She said quietly, as if fearing that the plaza could hear us, "The Camel is recruiting my son. This is a knife in my heart. He's only 13. "And what does he say about this?" "His friends have gone over to the Camel." "When your friends go, you go. In the sovereign state of Chihuahua, 13-year-old assassins are common. The Camel wants to give him a gun and show him how to use it." She was gazing into the water of the fountain as at something holy. "But my boy has been going to the school for social improvement. He wants to become something better." I'd spent my years in the monastery making up for a single bad moment of my own. Like her son, I wanted to become better, so I was sympathetic to her problem. She dipped her hand in the water, her small fingers playing in the ripples. "My husband is dead. He was shot one night." People were often shot at night around Modelo, for reasons that usually had to do with the Camel. She said, "I'm alone in this matter." "Perhaps not," I said. She lifted her face toward mine. I saw the struggle of 13 years in her eyes, to raise a son in poverty, yet hope that he escapes the corruption that breeds everywhere in the sovereign state of Chihuahua. I followed her from the plaza. She said, "The cartel devils know that if a boy is older, he may think about what will happen to him. At 13, he doesn't think. He grabs a gun and shoots someone." She led me to the place where her son was to meet the recruiter. It was a bus stop, and across the street was a restaurant. Parked in front of it was an SUV with the window rolled down. The man at the wheel was a Camel assassin named Bustamante. He swaggered around Modelo each day in aviator sunglasses, gold chains gleaming on his neck. The bus from the School for Social Improvement pulled to the curb, and the woman pointed out her son to me as he stepped down. Then she withdrew so that he wouldn't see her. He was walking toward the SUV when I intercepted him. "Do you like horses?" He looked at me, startled. I continued, "Horses can tell a predator by its eyes." I was breaking the momentum of his thought. The one he'd been.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.